Hi everyone. In this video, we will discuss how to perform the full structural SCM model using AMOS. In previous videos, we have developed and tested the confirmatory factor analysis or CFA model. We achieved good model fit in the post hoc analysis by adding several error term covariance and removing item 12. This test has confirmed the CFA model. In another video, we tested and confirmed the reliability, conversion validity, and discriminant validity of the factor structure. Thus, we can conclude that we have a good model fit CFA and reliable and valid instrument. The next step is to test the full structure model. This full structure model shows the relationships among constructs based on the ground theory. Basically, based on the ground theory and literature review, we develop a theoretical model showing relationships among factors or latent variables. In this model, we have exogenous and endogenous variables. First, I would like to show you how to convert the CFA model to the SEM model without creating the path diagram from scratch. Here is the CFA model we have. You need to make sure to save this file as a new file to avoid losing the CFA file. Then we need to remove the covariance among constructs. On the left, we select Erase Objects button and select the double arrows in the CFA model. They will be removed. Since the diagram has been linked to the data, we do not have to do it again. We have three separate constructs, and we need to connect them to represent our theoretical model. For example, in this case, we have a model of two endogenous latent variables, or dependent variables, which are F2, depersonalization, and F3, personal accomplishment. We have one exogenous latent variable, or independent variable, which is F1, emotional exhaustion. To make it easy to see, we keep F1 and F2 on the left and move F3 to the right. As done before, we need to select items of this factor, including error terms, items, and the factor itself. We do not have to select the arrows. Make sure to select the right ones. Then on the left, click Move Objects, and then drag and drop all items to the right. Then we use the Rotate Indicator button to rotate all items of this construct and move them to the right. That will give us a clean look model. Now we create three hypotheses. The first hypothesis is that emotional exhaustion negatively influences personal accomplishment. And we add an arrow from F1 to F3 to represent this hypothesis. The second hypothesis is that depersonalization negatively influences personal accomplishment. And we add an arrow from F2 to F3 to represent this hypothesis. We'll have a third hypothesis. Emotional exhaustion positively influences depersonalization. Then we add an arrow from F1 to F2 for this hypothesis. This is a simple SEM model for the purpose of this video. AMOS can handle much more complex structural models. So if you have a big model, you do not have to worry. Another important step in this process is to add a residual item for all endogenous or dependent variables. So for F2 and F3, we need to add a residual item. In order to do that, we select Add a unique variable on the left and add that item to F2 and F3. We do not need this item for F1 because F1 is exogenous variable. We'll need to add names for these residual items. Double-click on the item to open the object properties window. For variable name for F3, we call this Res3. For F2, we call it Res2. Note that the fixed value of 1 is automatically added to the item. This is to ensure the model identification. For example, what happens if I delete these fixed values for Res2 and Res3? Double click to open the objective properties Under parameter step, delete one from regression weight box. We do the same for rest two. Then run the model. We notice that the model ran, but does not have this model with outputs. We look at the text output, and it's indicated that the model is probably unidentified. And to achieve identifiability, it is necessary to impose additional two constraints. Basically, the model cannot run. In this case, to fix the issue, we add the fixed value of 1 back to residual items for F2 and F3. Basically, we tell AMOS that these values will not be estimated, and we use the fixed values of 1 for the residual values. We will run the model again. This time, the model runs well. If we select the model with outputs, we can see the regression weights on the diagram. For example, for hypothesis 1, we see a negative regression weight indicating a negative relationship between F1 and F3. Similarly, we notice a negative relationship between F2 and F3 and a positive relationship between F1 and F2. We need to look at the detailed outputs in the text. Under variable summary, it shows the list of observed variables and unobserved variables. For example, F2 and F3 are unobserved endogenous variables and F1 is unobserved exogenous variable. Let's look at the model fit. These fit indices are almost the same as the model fit we achieved for the CFA model. As you can see, since we have achieved acceptable model fit for the CFA, we do not have much problem with the model fit for the full SEM model. That is why it's important to ensure the model fit for the CFA model first. For the post-hoc analysis, we review MI values under modification indices. As indicated before, we focus on high MI values for the covariance between error terms and regression weight between an item and a factor, representing cross-loading situation. In addition, when we run the full SEM model, we need to pay attention to IM values suggesting a regression weight between two factors, indicating a potential new relationship in the model. If a MI value suggests a new relationship, a careful consideration should be taken before adding this new relationship. To demonstrate the post-hoc analysis at the full SEM model level, I will remove the arrow between F1 and F2. Suppose our initial model has only two hypotheses. F1 negatively influences F3, and F2 negatively influences F3. Let's run the model. The model runs and gives us the results. Let's look at the model fit. In this case, the model fit is not good, with CFI, AGFI, and NFI less than 0.9. RMSEA is 0.072. Thus, we have poor model fit. To fix this, we need to examine the MI values. First, we note a high MI value of 294, but this is between residual item and a factor, so we will disregard this. As we continue to screen through MI values, we see another very high MI value of 294 between F2 and F1. This means MI value suggests a potential new relationship between these two constructs, F1 to F2. Again, SEM is a theory-driven method, so we need to examine this new relationship based on the ground theory and the literature review to see if this relationship makes sense. Suppose this relationship seems fit to the theory and makes sense. In other words, the higher the emotional exhaustion, the higher the depersonalization. So we add this new hypothesis to the model by adding an arrow from F1 to F2 and run the model. This is the output that we had before with good model fit. To interpret the results, we'll look at estimates. P-values for all three hypotheses are less than 0.001. You can see three asterisks here, indicating the significant relationship between F1 and F2, between F1 and F3, and between F2 and F3. the sign of the relationship support our hypotheses. Specifically, the relationship between F1 and F2 is positive, between F1 and F3 is negative, and between F2 and F3 is negative. So we can conclude that all three hypotheses are supported. Note that these are unstandardized regression weights, which are not comparable. To compare the effects on each relationship, we should use standardized regression weights. The standardized regression weights have the value between 0 and 1 and can be used to compare the effects across relationships. In this case, we can conclude that the effect of F1 on F2 is strongest with a regression weight of 0.554. In addition, both F1 and F2 have a negative effect on F3, but F2 has a stronger effect of negative 0.288. Having said that, in the report, I recommend reporting the standardized regression weight, the t-value or CR value on this output, and the p-value for each hypothesis. And you need to conclude whether a hypothesis is supported or not. The last thing I want to show you is to fit the model on one page. We can note that this model is oversized and does not fit on the page. To fix this, first we need to switch the page orientation from portrait to landscape. We go to View and select Interface Properties. Under Page Layout, we select Landscape Letter and click Apply. To fit everything on one page, we can click the button Resize the Path Diagram to fit on a page. Now we have a nicely arranged model that fits on a page. That is how to perform a full structural model using AMOS. Thank you and bye now.